All right, so here we go, early round one, and as many of you know, this is his first time on the main card. He's been a prelim machine throughout his UFC career, but the wins have started to pile up, and now he's gonna take his shots at one of the division's elite. More eyeballs, obviously the crowd is full, back to the ninth here, main card has started. We'll see if he can get off to a good start tonight. Lands with the kick there, no pad on that foot.
No shin guard, he's taking all of that kick every time he throws it.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Jones gets caught with that punch. Well, you saw the tail of the tape, he has a reach advantage and made good use of it there with that punch. Oh, he slams his opponent down. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. All right, north-south position now. We'll see who transitions first. Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to fold him. Yeah, absolutely.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
Oh, that's a nice strike.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very
great time on that move.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strike.
Oh, nice job to get back up again. You don't want to hang out on the ground with this guy. 30 total strikes have landed for Curtis Blades.
We got him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Blades gets another takedown. Largely, he's a striker, but the wrestling is there tonight. All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra hop in your step when you talk about fighters working out of this half guard.
Oh, man, I like half guard as a top fighter. I understand half guard as a bottom fighter. Don't want to be there. It's
right.
Very dangerous. But if you are there, you have to be winning the position of the underhook. It opens up so many opportunities for you to either escape or sweep.
Oh, that'll work. The ground and pound strike is good. That kick blocked by Curtis Blades. Another leg kick for good measure. So doing a really good job with that weapon here tonight. And if you're trying to slow your opponent down, mission accomplished so far.
When you can land that many leg kicks, you start to affect the movement. You start to affect the hands. Everything changes when you're blasting someone over and over and over with leg kicks. And you start to see the damage, not only in the legs, but in the facial expression.
Blades' strike attempt there is blocked.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Another takedown lands.
And plenty of time with which to work. 30 seconds to go in the round. And he's back up again. So the takedowns have been there, as have the get-ups.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick. Such a fast leg kick.
All right, single collar tie now. stuffs the takedown, no problem. All right, let's take a look back at some of the highlights, DC. A lot of leg kicks for good measure in that round.
I mean, leg kicks are the key. You watch people win fights with just leg kicks, especially in this game. I mean, it is my strike of choice. I love the animation when I've landed so many leg kicks that my opponent just kind of waves me off and the fight gets stopped. Keep throwing them. If they're not going to check them, keep throwing the leg kick.
You ready?
Head kick attempt, it is blocked by Blades. Well, he continues to find the openings tonight. Beautiful connection with a punch there.
Accuracy at
the best head kicks you'll ever see.
You don't really stand after you take a head kick like this. That is such toughness to even be on the feet right now. Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Good series of kicks by him there, DC. He has certainly found his range on the feet.
I mean, when you don't check, you're going to continue to get blasted with kicks. His opponent has not deterred him from keeping on throwing those kicks.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Close guard. Well, you got to stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch. Visibly limping here.
Beautiful punch. Looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may float a right hand out.
Quick level change now.
He went single into a high cross. Oh, he's taking this dude for a ride. Oh, well, takes him for a ride. What a fantastic takedown.
All right, he's in a half-guard position here, DC, and in a good spot to dole out a lot of damage, I would think.
A lot of damage can be done from the half-guard. You sit back on that leg, you press down into your opponent, you drop elbows, you drop punches. What is very key is you controlling the underhook on the far side. If you give up that underhook, your opponent can use the half-guard to build up to an elbow, sweep, or just chase down a single leg.
Just over 3 minutes to go. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Oh, worked hard to get up again, but he looks like he's compromised. And there comes the separation now. 75 total strikes have landed for the heavyweight Curtis Blades. And connecting on a pretty good clip as well, 55%. Well, he worked that, he'll do it!
He got him!
Well, it's not every day in the UFC that you see a fight ended due to a leg kick, but that one was absolutely devastating. He took away that lead leg of his opponent, who became a one-legged fighter, and then it became just a matter of time. So somewhat anticlimactic here tonight, but not for the winner as he gets one of the bigger TKO wins of his UFC career. So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the win by TKO. That is one they'll be talking about for quite some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 30 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by TKO, John Bones Jones!
Well, could you imagine what the celebration is like in his hometown right now after he gets the TKO win tonight? He said he wanted to leave the judges out of it.